फ्रेंड्स वेलकम बैक। द लास्ट वीडियो सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ JPA, स्प्रिंग बूट JPA, इन विच वी हैव सॉ सम बेसिक फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट एंड हाउ टू कनेक्ट विथ MySQL डेटाबेस, हाउ टू कॉन्फिगर द MySQL DB इन द एप्लीकेशन YAML फाइल, एप्लीकेशन डॉट YAML फाइल, एंड वी हैव डन सम स्मॉल क्रूड ऑपरेशंस यूजिंग द MySQL, राइट? That is called saving the user control. That is a one to many mapping. We have seen the one to many mapping. User is a there is an entity model, user object and address object. This is a one to many concept, right? One to many concept. One per user can have a multiple address. That we have seen. We were able to save the user object and address object while doing the while calling a save method. This is what we have saw the last time. After completion of this particular session, I saw one defect. I am not able to insert user ID in the address table. User ID in the address table, right? That is not able to not inserted. Also, there is a one join table was created. Join table. I don't want that join table. So for one to many relationship, I don't want the join table. I want to exclude to create the join tables for this. Okay, so the last time I have not used that mapped by user, this address object mapped by user. This particular attribute we have to use. If you not use this attribute, JPA creates a join table for user and the address table. I don't want that join table now. Say in the case of many to many, we can use a join table, but one to many, we don't have to maintain the join table at all. So I use the mapped by equal to user. So it's excluding to create a join table. Okay. Then there is another that this is the one problem, and another one is I not able to insert a user ID inside address table. Okay. Even I have given here, but it's not able to insert a user ID. That is the one. I was facing some issue after completion of I noticed that issue after completion of the session. So to fix that issue, I have done some workaround. Some reason JP expecting to set user object inside the address table, address object. Okay, then only the user ID sitting into populated, user ID is populating in the address table. Okay, otherwise not. In the previous session, I have not used this particular code. Only I have this one. I am taking the JSON object as a user from the client side. From the client side, I am sending the user information as a request body. That user information just I'm passing to service classes. This creating a new user, new address object. Both records get populated, but address table not having a user ID. It's a null. That's the issue. To fix that issue, what I did is from the user I'm taking the address list. I'm iterating the each address I'm setting this user. See, when after doing this, I'm able to set the user ID in the address table. Okay, this is the second issue I noticed. Okay, this code I have been updated the Git session 23 folder. You can take it from there. Okay. Now we're going to see many to many relationship. The same example, I'm going to use a many to many example. We're going to see how to implement that. For that, I have come up with already the code. I have written a code for that. I don't have to spend much time in the part of video writing a code. So just copy and paste and explain the code how to implement the many to many. Relationship. Okay, best example of many to many relationship is user and role. I will going to show them many to many relationship using user object and role object. Okay, okay. Just quickly, I want to show one to many relationship demo now. Last time I was not able to store address user ID in the address table, right? That is fixed now. Already my server is started. I'll going to send a request. Okay, see here. I just found request available here. I'm going to send a request now.
See response coming. Status is 201 created. When look at the table, refresh. User table got populated. User ID is 1. Address table got populated. User ID is 1. User ID is now populated now. Okay. Now we'll see how to implement many to many relationship. Okay. I have a user object here. In this user object, I modified, added one more field. I think one more field called this one, many to many roles field. Okay. I'll going to add that role field here. Role class is not available. Just copy that role entity from here. Copy it and paste it here. Okay. In the role in the user table, what happened? So base object here. Base object. Okay. In the user table, using many to many annotation, I am giving the many to many relationship to the role.class. See, many to many target entity equal to role.class, cascade equal to cascade type all. That meaning I can do all the operations. Join table. Using this join table annotation, I am defining how my join table should look. Okay, how my join table should look. Name equal to user underscore roles. Name equal to user underscore is my join table. Join column. This add join column meaning we are referring the current entity object. Our current entity object is user.java, right? That reference column is a ID. The reference column is a ID. When you look at base object, there is a reference to column is a ID. I have mentioned we have to mention rec ID here. What is touchy? So I need to mention rec ID. Reference to column is a rec ID. Then inverse join column is whatever many to many object declared here, role, right? That part we need to mention inverse join column. Join column equal to name equal role ID. I want to create a role ID, role underscore ID as a column, and a reference to column is an ID I mentioned here. When you go here, when you say same thing, base object should have a rec ID only, right? So we need to use a rec ID only here. Okay. Now user underscore role table will have a two column called user ID coming from rec ID. You are referring a rec ID, role ID, another column that is referring from rec ID from the role table. Okay. When you look at a roles table, roles object, I am saying the same many to many target entity equal to user class mapped by roles. Mapped by roles meaning what are the roles defined in the user, right? User object. User object. So I am referring this mapping here. Okay, through this I am joining that role table to in my role object to my user object using mapped by. Same thing, cascade equal to cascade type equal to all. Okay, that's it. This is a many to many relationship. Now when I'll going to remove this as of now. Okay, I'll explain later. Also I'll going to remove here also I mentioned it. No, here no. Okay, this is the many to many relationship. One user can have multiple roles. One role can have multiple person. That is the concept here. Okay. Now I'm going to stop the server. Then go to database and drop this table. I want to stop the server now. Run, stop. See here, role table creating, user table created, user and record roles also created. Okay, created. If you look at the database, user table, I'm going to close on user table, role table, then address table. User roles, role tables are created successfully. Now I want to do some adding a new role. I want to add a new user. I want to add a new role to that user. I'm going to see the user controller. Okay, when I look at the user controller, this is a class. I have already written some methods in the user controller for one to many address relationship. I have done this code right. I don't want to delete this with address. Okay, just going to copy this. No, you can go and take that. Always the code is available in the repository, right? You can go and take it. Okay. I'm going to copy this method. Just copy this method here. Okay. Here, this, when you look at this code, whenever user send a user object, I am saving that user. Successfully saving the user, new user will be coming with IDs. That user information I am showing in the response, part of the response. When you look at the user service, nothing here, right? So here is only changes is I have to change the JSON request body. This particular request body I have to change. Previous example, in the one to many relationship, I have a user in the JSON user data, address data. Now I need to add a role data too. Okay. That JSON already I have constructed here. Okay. User in. See here the JSON. This is the user information. These are users' address information. I want to add two roles to that user. That is the roles, ID, name, description. Description is administrator. Role name is admin. Okay. When you look at the role table, when you see the role table, I have name, description, users. Right. This is for. Many-to-many relationship I have defined here. The only two column we have: string, role name and a description. That name and description I have here. Since this role object having the user, that by default having a null value. Okay, that is no need to mention here. I am going to remove that because we are not going to do that. Here also we can remove that. Okay. Also, since you are going to create a new user, right? I don't want to create pass IDs and that. Here also we have a ID. Don't want to pass IDs, address ID. Okay, now we have a JSON is ready. Just copy this JSON. Then paste it here. We have already user table, role table with no data. Now I'm going to we need to restart the server now. We don't need to restart the server. Okay. I'll going to send a request now. Bad request. JSON parser error. Okay, there are some JSON bug. Whenever you do some manual changes in the JSON, better you check with the JSON viewer. Our JSON is correct or not, we can validate it, right? format. See, here is a comma. Comma is not required. This comma is not required. We are going to send now. See, I got the successful response now. Got the successful response. Let's check that database now. User table. See, we have a user table. We have data in the user table now. Go to role table. For this user, I want to create two roles, right? One is accountant, another one is admin, right? Let's see. We have two roles. See, two roles created. Now this two role is associated with this particular user. That association where it will be available, that the join table. That join table. When you go to join table, user ID is 11. This user ID 11 having a two role, 1 and 2. Okay. My user ID is 1. This user having two role card, one is admin, or two is an accountant. That association you can see here. This is the purpose of joining table. Okay. Also, I am passing this address data, right? Address data part of the user information. When you see here, see address also populated, also user ID is populated here. So, looks like very simple, right? For many to many relationship using JPA. JPA makes our life very easy to do these kind of operations. Okay, in the next video, we're going to see how to save roles. How to save roles? In this example, while saving a user, we're attaching some roles to that user, right? The next example, while saving a role, I want to associate some users to that role, and we'll see how to get all the users. Users and the roles, all the information and other examples. Okay. Please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh K7.